Warte. Start going through it. New icons found. Are those images in here? And that's all good. And I need to reply to this with this. Twitter embed's not working. Weird. Weird, weird, weird. All right. This is Wasn't this just Kizaru Fuji? Oh no, this was Shiki. This is PR Shiki. Sick. Right, Sakura DB, the characters, book ID. Hell yeah, Ray's Max is in there. And some other movie characters, Double Down, Rika, and Tempo. I remember those guys. It was Karina's crew of friends. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 new characters with a Nami and Karina legend. 4002 to 4006. Is that everything that's on there? Just that I'm not ripping. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just those five. Rip unit. Okay, the full check didn't get anything. So, rip unit. Let's go all the way down to the bottom. Strength and Quick is a fun combination for Nami, although Free Spirits re-rolled the whole way through is kind of dumb. Alright, rip unit. Now rip details. And this is where the fun starts. Let's grab the images. Oh no, they were the restaurant owners that they were helping, right? Is that what they were? I forget. Then Japan. Nice. All those are in. Alright, let's look at what they do. Karina. Free spirits reroll, strength quick. Nothing crazy there. G orb centric. HP by 1.2. Attack by 4.25 when they have strength recovery tandem universal booster. Okay. When they have G orbs, or 4.75 when they have G orbs, otherwise 3.75. Interesting. Adds an extra piece of treasure and doubles amount of bellies earned. Ooh. They're buggy and they double bellies. They double drops. Cooldown by 2 turns, heals 800, whatever. Swap, reduces slot bind completely, changes adjacent, including block, to G. Changes attack multiplier of G to 2x for 1 turn. Hell yeah. boost base attack of all characters by 300. Ooh. Slot bind, adjacent, block and adjacent to G. Attack multiplier to 2.25 for 3 turns. And then 300 for 3 turns. Special. Ooh, they have different specials per character. Nami reduces barriers by one turn. Karina reduces cooldown of enemies by, duration of barriers by two. Karina does cooldown of everyone by two. Nami reduces resilience and percent damage reduction. Karina reduces threshold and increased defense. Nami reduces paralysis. Karina reduces attack down. Nami reduces damage by 90%. Karina cuts it over 5,000. Nami boosts attack. Karina boosts orbs effects. Both of which can be overwritten. They're strong, but they can be overwritten. Weird. And then transforms. That's kind of crazy. Oh my god, they're actually really good. Holy moly, that's actually really good. That's kind of nuts. That's kind of crazy. I'm gonna be honest. Turn cooldown too. That is a crazy special ability. Actually cool unit for once. Somebody at Bandai cooked and made a character that's actually interesting. Like, insane. No support. Sailor Despair, cooldown reduction, pinch healing. No fun rush or final tap or anything. Yeah, cooldown reduction, big joke. Only useful in maybe Kizuna. Evade silence, damage and free spirit by 30%. That's a weird combo. You can't really double dip with that, that's unfortunate. Universal HP, speed, and recovery up. If Straw Hats or Tesoro crew are on the team, enemy defense down level 3. Eh, whatever. Not that great. Their special targets 2 enemies with high special cooldown for a 40% delay. Level 4 defense down twice. Is that for the whole thing? Like, this entire thing they just do twice? So they could delay potentially your, like, 4 of your characters. Or, like, if 2 of them are still, like, at 100% and then the other ones are at, like, 0, she could just chunk them down to 20. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that's worded that way. Because why else would it be worded that way? I think it is that, because why else would it be worded this way? You don't need to apply a defense down 2 times, you just double the effect of the defense down. So yeah, it has to be that they hit the delay twice. That's pretty neat. That's really creative, actually. It might be neat to see this in a super defensive team. Because they're like HP speed recovery. A defense team would be fun. All free spirit cerebral. All the way through. Namekrina, very cool. Rise max. Yeah, 24 second cooldown time. Attack by 3.25 gives a chance of earning another treasure. 2 turns cooldown, silence by 6. Applies various effects depending on character's support character's type, captain type, character's orb, and current HP percentage when launching the special. What? What? Oh dear. I'm gonna have to do some digging to figure out what he does. What? That's crazy that they just said that. That's all they said. Okay. Okay. God, what would that be under? Help. Event help. Leader action help. Skill action help. Event help. No, it's not there. God, that's crazy. Bandai say they want to have fun all of a sudden. I don't know. I have no clue. That is crazy. First things first. Character. Rise max is character number. Rise max 13473. 13473. 13473. That is literally what it says. Nothing additional. These are icons you shouldn't have downloaded. No, really shouldn't have. Pull the slot. Yeah, this is crazy that they were just like, we can just do this shit. Hey, we can just. You wanted to see us cook? That's us cooking. And then we're gonna see a drought of anything this creative for months. And they pull it out this month for whatever reason. Thanks for the follow, Leo T Riot Tinto. 9.5 anniversary is gonna be pouring as hell. Yeah. Support skill effect. Expanded tandem. Is there nothing else? Changes supported character's orb and adjacent to G. Oh god, that's so good. Cooldown reduction, bleh. Crit. That's crazy. Quest leader material guide.
surely they have something in there to explain what he does. It's probably gonna be images.
Just saw that Nami Karina has the forced free spirit still. Yeah, they would have been fun as like a slasher striker character and not cerebral free spirit.
Could have been cool. We don't really get that many slasher Namis. Map game boss. No, it's none of the map game stuff. I'm not gonna check gacha right now. Composition rate schedule. Oh, I know what this is. I think. And map Coliseum, Jewel Event, Transition, Trial Tech, Trail, Login. It's none of the ones that have help in the name. I couldn't see one under ability. Team skill? No, this is... Yeah, what's that? In time. Skill, action, help. Sugar and... Toki.
Yeah,
I don't know where to find it. Event help. Nope, nothing in there. Yeah. Okay. I have no clue where that potentially could be. So I have no way of checking that. Only G-Orbs allowed debuff? I mean, they can just do that. They can make it so that way matching, like, the orb matching buff slash debuff that they added can make it so that way even if you have beneficial orbs, it will give you a less than 1x multiplier. Like, they could do that with that debuff. They can do some wacky stuff with that debuff. Like, even if you make the orbs matching, they'll still be bad. So, I'm waiting for them to get creative with that. I could definitely see it. Alright, well, I don't know what to put for Raze Max then for a bit. 20 turn cooldown, interestingly enough, though. Bit on the long side. Must be pretty good for 20 turns. Yeah, I don't know what to say. And then Corazon Law finally shines. Well, yeah, kind of. Alright, double down Rika and Tempo. Attack by 3.25. Reduces damage when they don't attack. Reduces silence by 7 turns. Dex orb is beneficial. If your crew has an orb boost, boost color affinity by 1.75. Cannot be removed. Cool. Then removes all beneficial effects placed on crew, reduces silence by 7 turns, and boosts orb effects for 1 turn. Huh. Yeah, that's interesting. That's pretty cool. Oh, Raze Max is Driven Slasher. He actually might have a pretty good set of units that he can play around then. Who's giving orb boost this treasure map, I guess? Yeah, I should be able to pull that stuff too. I can whip out my fancy script. And I might have to do some live script editing today. But yeah, alright, let's look at the treasure map unit. Powerhouse Shooter. Thank God they're not driven. They're universal, they're quick, we knew that. Boost attack by 4.25, boost their attack by 5x. I think that's just their own attack by 5x. I believe that is correct. They have the Legend Tesoro gimmick. Hitting a perfect reduces your attack. Heals by 777 at the end of a turn. Boost belly by 1.5. Okay, whatever. Increases damage dealt to strength and to dex. Donning the golden armor. Reduces bind by 7. Heals crew by 7,000 HP. Reduces defense by 77%. I get the joke, but that's unfortunate. Doubles damage to defense down enemies for 3 turns. 3 turns. And if you hit 4 greats, reduces enemies' defense by 77% for 1 turn, ignoring immunity. Interesting. That's actually pretty usable for a lot of stuff. That's pretty neat. Unfortunate that it's 77% and not 100%, but still pretty neat. Like, it would have been nice if this was 100%. Support. Once per adventure, if inflicted with Bind or Despair, reduces Bind and Despair on Tesoro and Karina. That's very good. That's extremely good. That's actually insane. That's a huge, like, plus one to any Karina and Tesoro unit now, from now on. So whenever we get the chance to use them, or if you get, like, Nami and Karina, who are gonna be boosted on every treasure map from now on. So you want two copies, one for Bind and one for both, yeah. If you want to play like that, yeah. You would have to get two. Oh yeah, and then they have barrier penetration and reduce hunger and enrage. So that's also pretty good. PvP, evade silence, quick crit, and accuracy. It's whatever. Debuffs enemies' accuracy and speed. And if your HP is below 50%, then HP cuts one person by 30%. Very bad. Oh yeah, I gotta grab Spandam. Versus Spandam. What? Alright, let me look at that file. Foistable. Let's push this and say units info out. Because I'm not gonna do all this tonight. I'm just gonna get the information out. Spandam was in film gold. Yeah, but it's just one quest. Lucci will also be there. It would have been an interesting time to give us a Spandam from gold. That could have been cool too. Oh well. Quests. Quest ID. No, let me sort by update. Timestamp. Oh, Spandam is one of the treasure map bosses. I don't know why. I thought I was Spandam up here, and I was like, I thought it was separate from this stuff. I just missed it when I was reading it. Okay. Hmm. Heart versus Heavenly Demon. Supposedly Tesoro Ship is in Treasure Map Shop. One second. Hold on. 56... 1001576. Rip Treasure Map Gimmicks. 576. 593. Okay, and that'll be good. Each movie gets one batch, so a doubt we'll have Spandam as one of them. Yeah. I mean, we can apparently always come back to movies whenever they feel like it every year. All it takes is Toei throwing the movie in theaters. So. Brandon in subreddit Discord said 20,000 tickets. That is probably correct. I can check that now. Hold on. Exchange. Prize exchange. Sort by. Update timestamp. Yamato added to the treasure map shop. Grand Tesoro ship right there. Required point, 20,000, yeah. Grand Tesoro, rare recruit, somewhere. And that looks like that's it. That's the only things added to Rayleigh Shop. It's cheap, would expect it to be like 200k. Honestly, yeah, for how good that ship was, very surprising that it's not much more expensive. Alright. Let's see. Data mining, Python, DBRIP, output. Stage, gimmicks, Greenline, New World. Spandam, Dex, recommended characters. Alright. Despair. Special use limit to 4 turns of defense, delay immunity, 4 turns of resilience. That doesn't look horrible. Rise max, dex. 6 turns, reduce damage taken by 90%. Changes. Empty, type, G recovery, tandem, and bomb into block. Attack down. Crewmate special reverse. Defense up. Threshold damage reduction. And normal attack only, and then on death, 4 turns of cruise damage taken times 2. Is that the... I think that's damage reflection. Oh no, that's just increased damage taken. That's a weird way of wording it, but I guess that is, yeah. Fixed 1000 HP recovery and then nullifies damage. That's a weird revive. Wording seems different this time around. Yeah, wording's been changing lately. Karina is strength. 5 turns, reduce damage taken all the slots to badly matching. 6 turns of defense up, normal attack only. 2 turns of chain-based attack down for under 3.5. A rainbow orb barrier. This is Tesoro. Yeah, Legend Tesoro is suggested for this. For 3 turns of the target status, reduce certain status effect turns by 2. Set chain multiplier. This is Intimidate. Reduces 2 turns of chain lock whenever you do it. So you need 3 turns. So have Tesoro. Yeah. I don't know why they don't just say Intimidate, reduce 2 turns, blah blah blah. Whatever. Lucci is Int. Suggest new batch. Top left special reverse by 2 turns. 3 turns bottom row. This is stage 1. Bottom row blow away. 1 turn slot barrier tandem orb 3 times. What? This is stage 1. I mean, yeah, I guess this is the Kizaru Fujitora fight. What else would it be? Okay. Stage 2. There's a stage 1 boss. That is crazy. Despair, special bind, attack down, and then on death, full HP recovery. Oh, hold up. Hold the heck up, quest. They're not even giving extra for Lucci. It's not like he even gives extra points. Why is he so hard? Why? Why is he so hard? They don't even give extra points. Oh, it looks like Halloween Doflamingo is back. That's what Heart versus Heavenly Demon was. I forgot that that was the name of that. Alright, and then Tesoro, final boss. Stage 2. 91% health cut. 5 turns attack down. Special reverse of top row by 2 and middle row by 4. Normal attack only and threshold damage reduction. And then full heal and I assume run away. And then he deals 30,000 damage, so you have to heal. You definitely need to heal. Mid-map fight against Lucci it is. Yeah, it seems like it. Unless it's like secretly easier than what it looks like. Yeah. Stage 3. Bunch of shit into block. 7 turn special bind, 6 turn paralysis, 6 turn resilience, 1 turn slot barrier. I can only imagine how much of this garbage that Rise Max is going to be able to just be like, snap his fingers and he takes care of it. Like, because I have no clue what he does. Slot barrier for block orbs. Have fun with that. Okay. And then immunity to everything except delay. And then the intrusion is versus them. Percent damage reduction, an orb boost that's weak. Six turn special bind, all orbs, all that to Cyanint. Normal attack only. Already, nice. Top and bottom row, orbs to super block. Attack down for six turns. Immunity, six turn defense up. Here's where you, yeah, that's. Are you intended to use them against themselves? Slot barrier G. Two times. That's crazy. That's insane. So somebody was having fun creating the characters, and then somebody else at Bandai was like, you're having too much fun. Stop it. And they designed the treasure map. Treasure map number 74, it looks like. Yeah, 74. Rip boosters. Map game 74. Grand Line, New World. I need those. Don't need ship stuff right now. I don't need this. Thanks for the follow, Chubame Bachi. Thanks for following. That's Pirate King. This is going to be the treasure map to rank, if you rank, because everyone's going to look at this and go, nah. Honestly, yeah. If you need your screenshot for the memories. Baccarat and Dice and Mr. Tanaka. Yeah, Yeah, I'm kind of sorry that I wasted all my luck last treasure map getting those. Now Pacepun's having issues. All right, and then quest information. Well, I need to do some script editing. So rip, treasure map gimmicks. Do I have a normal rip gimmicks? Stage gimmicks. I don't have an H or a G. I don't care about that. Gimmick JSON. Oh. I don't want any of this. Alright, and now if I go to here, and I sort by quest, Smoker, the White Hunter, 15012, Ripkinix. Gimmicks.txt. Ah, it doesn't always have recommended characters. Yeah, it doesn't have. What is the error? Ah. Stage gimmicks. Smoke the Right Hunter. No recommended characters. Nice. Special themed red tickets. Sugarfest tickets. Cool. Here's the East Blue Link. Okay, now I need to make the Grand Line Link. Thank you. Okay, so that's smoker info. Lots of preempt damage on Grand Voyage and death hits. Yeah. Health cut. Death damage. Death damage. Incoming damage. Death damage. Yeah. Lots of death rattles and a lot of preemptive hits. And health cuts. Not sure who the intended character is, because it doesn't look like... Yeah. I don't think I'll be able to get his typing. Unless it says, like, what he changes type to? No. 6+ time skip Luffy. That would make sense if he reduced a special charge of top row characters. But he doesn't. I don't know. Not sure. Honestly, not sure. Oh my god. Still not working. Okay, that's done. What's next on my to-do? To-do. Grand Voyage update. That was technically with it. Voyage stage mechanics. Sugarfest info. Okay. Gasha. Has 3 parts. Interesting. It doesn't specify that they're treasure map limited. OPTC girls. Treasure Sugofest. Step up in Nami Carrot. Oh, Nami Carrot didn't say it either. So yeah, probably Treasure Map Limited. I don't see why not. It's called the Treasure Map Sugofest. They're probably just Treasure Map Limited. And they just didn't include it because the name would be too long or something? I don't know. Probably Treasure Map Limited. It looks like there are a couple discount multi-pulls in there. Probably just the one. And that's it. No. Yeah, no, that's it. Nothing too special. Rumble season, featured character, and achievement titles. Rumble. Arena. Pirates Arena stage. Never mind, Pirates Arena. Settling the score with his life. Top screen display 10341. That's Shanks. I'd bet my bottom dollar that that's Shanks. 10341. 10341. Never mind, it's Zephyr. Man laying his life out. Whatever the hell it said. Okay, Zephyr getting his 6 plus. I was like, that sounded suspiciously like Shanks. But no, it was Zephyr. So Zephyr is the next. Six plus. Are we getting Treasure Map Limited Red tickets? I don't think so. I just know that Nami and Karina are probably Treasure Map Limited. Okay, and then achievement category. Nothing. Nothing. Is that correct? Yeah, there's nothing here. Would it not be by update timestamp? Would it be by server ID or something? Nope. That looks right. I guess they only do them for Super Pirate Rumble. They don't do them for normal Pirate Rumble. So this is probably just a normal Pirate Rumble month. I thought they still did stuff for normal Pirate Rumble. Okay, so it's Zephyr. Okay, here's the Grand Line gimmicks. And then New World gimmicks. I'm looking forward to Zephyr buffs, but they did his ship dirty. They could have done so much more with his ship. All, like, the smallest thing they could have done is made it so it's not just a shooter ship. They could have been like shooter fighter or shooter something else. Having him be pure shooter is a little bit constraining. Oh, Brandon got the recommended characters that I'm too lazy to get. Hyper getting super type added. Yeah, let's hope we're getting super type added to Zephyr. And it's not just a random thing they did for Tesoro. Alright, let's... everything that's in the info that I need to do. Save. I just need to get all these posts out now. Hope Zephyr gets super shooter. It'd be surprising if he got super quick instead, frankly. So hopefully he doesn't get it and get just relegated to being he needs Discord. Yeah, there we go. there. Except I need to add in 4003, and their units are going to be, who are the last dual units? Kizaru Fujitora, okay, so then it's going to be skip 4, so 7, 8, 9, 5, 5, 50, 5, 5, 5, 1, 5, 5, 5, 5, 3, 5, 5, 5, 4. Okay. And now I can run this. And I don't need that stage boosters there. Until I'll put stage boosters. There we go. Why am I doing this way? Page boosters. Pills, nope, it's table. Global treasure map. Ooh, kind of a bigger list. Sidebar, treasure map boosters. What's up, Hutsy? And Mass Saiyan? It's like busy Wednesday. Yup. A little bit busy. I'm gonna try to get this finished so I can sleep and then wake up tomorrow and do the actual database update. But I'll do the stuff that lets people start thinking about things. Unit is 4006. Okay, who's like 2.5x stats? Are all my 2.5x stats. Next one is what, 1.25? Okay. 1.25 stats. 1.25 stats. 1.25 stats. One of you are out of order, yeah. Right here, it's 1.25 stats. Okay. I should also check another thing for boosters real quick. Event. Character boost. Pirate arena map game. It doesn't look like there's this a boosted unit list for the Blitz Battle. Pseudo Blitz Battle. What time is it? It's 4:20 a.m. I was playing Minecraft and lost track of time. Good, my overflow barrel is working. Yeah, I'm quarrying out a big area. Because I want to build my house there. Why? Where'd you come from? I have a no soliciting sign. Fine, stay there. So yeah, I may have Kangwalled this entire quarry, clears out a huge void, so that way I can build a factory. It'd be a score event, right? Heart versus yeah, there were points associated with it. Gotcha. Interesting. Why did I not see that when I looked up the gacha? Because there's not like... No, there's not like friend point. Yeah. Cool. Available until October 31st. That's pretty neat. Python character graphic. Cool. I'll copy to this. Halloween collection, friend point recruit. Recruit Halloween outfit characters that appeared in past event quests. Until October 31st. PSD. Filter for the doofy thing. Thank you. was the title of... Settling the score with his life. Smoker, the White Hunter. Okay, so, yeah, then the that is everything I need to post on Twitter. ID greater than equal to 4002, ID less than equal to 4006. New icons, character information. I think that's everything I needed to do. Let's just go here. Let's say yoink. Posted on Discord. Thank you. Okay, that's too big. Okay, if I move the swamp. Okay, you still don't like it. Fine. Everything else, or are you gonna yell at me? I can fit everything else, just barely. Restaurant has the double down. Double down. Is that KFC? Yeah, it's KFC. Actually, nope. Excuse me, just barely too long of a message. I'll split it at Rumble. That's everything. I'll come back tomorrow. And do the rest of the database update, rewriting everything, etc., etc. And I'll catch you guys later.